सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमस्मदाचार्यपर्यंतां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ वनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः ॐ यो ब्रह्माणुजातिगुरो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तवं हृदयमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः कामनायान्तिकसंसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे Beginning with the third chapter, first pada. The third chapter is the sadhana pada. We looked at the prathamadhyaya, which was samanvayadhyaya. Then the dvitiyadhyaya was avirodadhyaya. Now, what is the sadhana to this brahma where there is samanvaya of all the shruti vakyas? So what is the sadhana, what is the means to achieve this Brahma, attain this Brahma Tattva? So there is a discussion on this topic of sadhana in the third chapter across the four padas. So the Vaiyasika Nyayamala says Tritiye Viratis Tattvam Padartha Parishodhanam Gunopasamhruti ज्ञान बहिरंग आदि साधनम. सो तृतीय विरति वैराग्य सी साधना साधन चतुष्टय संपत्ति हैज विवेक वैराग्य समाधि षट्क संपत्ति एंड मुमुक्षुत्व दैट इज द साधना चतुष्टय संपत्ति. वन हु हैज इच्छा इन मोक्ष, one who is a mumukshu, he should have these four sampattis. So what is that really drives to mumukshuta? So you have seen in Mundaka Upanishad as to the parikshalokan कर्मचितान ब्राह्मणो निर्वेदमायात. निर्वेद देर मीन्स वैराग्य. सो हैविंग एनालाइज वन सोन एक्सपीरियंसेस इन दिस जन्म एंड बाय एक्सट्रापोलेटिंग अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट दी एक्सपीरियंसेस इन अर्लियर जन्म ऑल्सो वुड हैव बीन लिमिटेड would have led to limited sukha, parikshalokan, which are karmajanya, karmachitan, brahmanaha nirvedamayat, brahmana would get nirveda vairagya. This is a sadharana result. There is absolutely no way that someone would analyze one's experiences and conclude that yes, I have achieved the ananda the way I wanted, I have achieved everything that I wanted and I have been able to hold on to it. That is definitely not conclusion of any buddhiman person. Person who has some intellect which is functional and he is using, if he is true to himself, he will conclude that I have not been able to hold on to the sukha that I have been searching in all vishayas through all my experiences. Even if there was sukha through such vishayas, I have not been able to hold on to it. So naturally it should lead to vairagya. And this is the fear really. When people say I am bored, they mean that whatever I have been doing, I have not got sukha. I want more and more sukha all the time. Limitless sukha, which should never go away. So more and more experiences are needed वन गेट्स डिस्ट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम दिस परस्यूट ऑफ यू नो सो टू से परस्यूट ऑफ हैप्पीनेस द ब्लिस विच इज गोइंग टू स्टे फॉर एवर वन इज वॉन्टिंग दैट बट हैज बीन फेलिंग ओवर एंड ओवर अगेन बिकॉज द मीन्स आर रॉन्ग इट शुड बी क्लियर दैट द मीन्स आर रॉन्ग हैड द मीन्स बीन करेक्टेड एंड आई हैव स्टेड द कोर्स नॉट ओनली इन दिस जन्म अक्रॉस अनादि जन्म एंड आई हैव नॉट बीन एबल टू अटेन द रिजल्ट सो इट वुड बी फूलिश टू कंटिन्यू सच मीन्स कंटिन्यू टू यूटिलाइज सच मीन्स विच हैव नॉट लेड टू द रिजल्ट यू हैव टू चेंज योर प्लान Anybody knows that if the means are not working repeatedly, then the means are wrong. So what is the means then? Vairagyam ayat. One would surely know that these means, hankering after vishayas to get sukha has not been right. It has not been a right pursuit. It has not been a right means. I have been misled. So there will be vairagya, one would withdraw from such means and think. So there is viveka and viveka janya vairagya. So vairagya is one that will make the person withdraw from other things that he has been trying to attain at least in this janma. Therefore shamadama will also result from this very vairagya. Viveka, just a little inquiry, can also lead to vairagya, and that vairagya will result in withdrawal from actions and hankering within, thinking about such vishayas. Because if you start thinking about such vishayas and do not inquire with buddhi, then the antakarana has already laid out a trap. One would start indulging again. So there would be actions resulting from this kama. Therefore, shama and dama both are needed. They will result from vairagya and then the other virtues will also follow. This in turn will finally make the person a mumukshu. So mumukshutvam is an end result. But if you look at it, the important part is withdrawing from all sorts of activities which have been wrong means to attain this nitya sukha. Therefore, vairagya is very important. That vairagya, viratihi, says the Vaiyasika Nyayamala, Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya says there, Tritiye, in the third Tritiye Adhyaye, viratihi, viratihi is vairagyam. And tattvam padartha parishodhanam. How will this vairagya be resultant? So pariksha lokan as per Mundaka Upanishad. So how do you do pariksha of this loka? You have to know who I really am. This jiva who is taught in the shastra, have I understood myself as that jiva or not? Do I know that samsari jiva also well? Let alone the asamsari jiva brahma, but do I know the samsari jiva well? What else can cause vairagya? So pariksha lokan, not only one's own experiences, but what does the shastra say about the experiences that we are unable to recall? We may be able to recall at most our childhood. We don't recall our own janma, let alone the earlier janma. So what does the shastra talk about me as samsari jiva across janmas? How is it that I have taken birth in the womb of my mother? How did I reach there from the earlier janma? What is my journey? So if you look at the journey as described by the Shastra, that alone can give vairagya. Samartha Ramdasa Swami in Dasa Bodha, he describes the jiva's condition in the womb in such a manner that one should get vairagya. Shastras discuss this. Shastras say that the condition of the jiva in the womb, although the food is taken care of the mother's food is the food of the fetus, unborn child, still the surrounding is filthy. सो द जीवा सफर्स. सो भगवान रामदास स्वामी सेज दैट द जीवा इज प्रेइंग ऑल द वाइल इन द वूम ट्राइंग ही हैज द मेमरी द जीवा हैज द मेमरी ऑफ द अर्लियर जन्म एंड हाउ ही रीच देयर एंड देन विद द स्ट्रगल दैट ही हैज विद द सराउंडिंग फिल्थ टॉर्मेंटेड एवरी मोमेंट ही प्रेज दैट आई विल नॉट रिपीट इट I'll not repeat all these papakarmas which has led to this janma. Just let me get through this. Just let me be born and then I'll follow dharma and then I'll be free. This is the prayer and promise that the jiva makes because of the suffering. In the suffering, many a jiva makes promise to Ishvara. Oh, let me just, you know, come out of this situation. I will quit this, I'll do that, I'll leave home. I'll never ever do any papa karma. All this is under the pressure of suffering. Jiva does not live up to it. Similarly, before being born, Jiva is completely immersed in suffering and makes all sorts of promises. As soon as the jiva is born, as soon as the indriyas are connected to the outer world, jiva forgets all that and starts working on one's own desires to meet the prarabdha result, samskaras which are accumulated across janmas. So what happens is this sadhana is lost on the jiva. It has to be retaught by the Shastras. In every Janma, the Jiva has to relearn. Unfortunately, if the Jiva has continued his sadhana had been doing sadhana in the earlier Janma, then being Kalyanakrut continues that at some point of time, when the time is appropriate, then the memory is triggered due to some circumstances, when the Punya fructifies and then Jiva continues the earlier sadhana. So this Jiva's journey itself leading to the Janma, final Janma in this Prapancha, that itself is Vairagya Karaka. So Viratihi, Vairagya, Tritiye Viratihi, Tattvam Padartha Parishodhanam. And what is the Artha of Tat Padartha and Tvam Padartha? By Swarupa you are Tatpadartha and Tvampadartha, this samsari jiva, if you inquire it is a samsari atma really. That is a teaching. And I have been a samsari. If I continue to be a samsari, then what kind of travel awaits me or what kind of travel I have taken, that leads to viratihi. And guna upasamhriti hi jnana bahirangadi sadhanam. Further what? Gunana upasamhruti. Whatever gunas are there, they are taken away by teaching. And then what is the bahiranga, antaranga ityadi sadhanas, they are discussed for jnana. Jnanena moksha. So what is the sadhana for moksha? Jnana. Finally we will say jnanameva moksha, but still sadhana for moksha is jnana. And that jnana, if you question into that jnana, what is the means to that jnana? So there is bahiranga, antaranga sadhana needed to understand how to attain that knowledge, which will lead to brahmaikya jnana and moksha. So that is this third adhyaya all about. Sadhana pada, sadhana adhyaya. पूर्वस्मिन् अध्याये ब्रह्मणि समन्वयस्य स्मृति न्याय श्रुति विरोध व्यासेधेन अनध्यवसाय लक्षण अप्रामाण्य प्रतिक्षेपे तार्तीय विचारो भवति इति हेतु हेतु मत भाव संगत्या अयम अध्यायः आरभ्यते. अयम अध्याय आरभ्यते. दिस अध्याय चैप्टर इज बिगन. फॉर व्हाट पर्पस इट इज बिगन? Or what is it that has led to this adhyaya? Hetu hetumat bhava sangati. सो देर इज अ हेतु हेतुमत भाव संगति अर्लियर अध्याय एंड वेरियस अधिकरण आर हेतु एंड दैट हेतु इज देयर फॉर दिस थर्ड चैप्टर देयर फॉर दिस चैप्टर इज वॉट हेतु मत हैज अ हेतु सो दिस इज अ फला ऑफ द अर्लियर चैप्टर एंड वॉट वॉज देयर इन द अर्लियर चैप्टर विच बिकेम द हेतु पूर्वस्मिन अध्याय ब्रह्मणि समन्वयस्य ब्रह्मणि समन्वयस्य द समन्वय विच वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द प्रथम अध्याय अंटू ब्रह्म दैट वॉज re-established by refuting the or that was strengthened by the negation or parihara of all the virodhas objections raised by the purvapakshi so smriti nyaya shruti virodha the virodha was shown with what all being accounted for smriti nyaya and shruti so shruti virodha was shown virodha with smriti was shown Between Shrutis there was Virodha, which the Purvapakshi was seeing wrongly. So there was apparent Virodha. Then with Smriti also, there was some Virodha pointed out. Then Nyaya, logically also, using Tarka, Nayayika's Darshana otherwise, there was Virodha shown. And that all sorts of Virodha, this Smriti Virodha, Shruti Virodha, Nyaya Virodha, all these Virodhas were countered so thereby vyasedhena through that countering anadhyavasaya lakshana apramanya pratikshepe so what was done is there was pratikshepa of apramanya which was the focus of the or the tatparya of the purvapakshi purvapakshi was saying there is no samanvaya or there is no pramanyam in your statement of samanvaya or the shruti itself therefore the earlier adhyaya countering the virodha itself took away the objection of apramanyam so that apramanya was anadhyavasaya lakshana There was nothing which was, as per the Purvapakshi, there is nothing to conclude as Samanvaya. So the effort that was taken by the Siddhanti, that itself is not leading to Pramanya. This was the Purvapakshi's Aropa. And that was countered. He says that you cannot conclude. You cannot have an adhyavasaya, you cannot have a conclusion. Nischaya is not there. Why? Because Virodha has been there, they cannot have Nischaya. Oh, this is the meaning. So, Samanvaya that you have concluded in the first chapter cannot hold water. Why? Because Shrutis are having Virodha with each other, Smriti and Shruti are having Virodha mutually, and Nyayata also there is Virodha. Therefore, अध्यवसाय इज नॉट पॉसिबल सो अनध्यवसाय लक्षण अप्रामाण्य दिस अप्रामाण्यम इज ड्यू टू वॉट रीजन बिकॉज यू आर अनेबल टू एसरटेन दैट दिस इज द मीनिंग इदम इत्थम वेन यू कैन कैनॉट से इदम इत्थम देन संशय विल लिंगर ऑन इफ संशय लिंगर्स ऑन देन वॉट इफ यू से स्तंभो वा पुरुषो वा इन अ डिमली लिट एरिया यू डू नॉट नो From a distance, if you want to walk that path and it's dimly lit, from a distance you see some shadow. At a further distance where you want to walk, you see some shadow there, or some not a shadow really, but you do not see the figure clearly. It is dimly lit. You are not sure whether it is a person waiting to who is a thief who is waiting to attack you and steal away things from you, or whether it is just a stump of a tree. So stambho va purusho va you do not know. So if that samshaya is there, then how it will lead to pramana? How will it become pramana and how will it lead to pramanyam? It won't. Therefore, similarly here, if there is a samshaya due to the virodha, anavadhyasaya lakshana apramanya is the resultant. And pratikshepe, what has been done is that such apramanya is not there because virodha was countered, therefore such pramanya apramanya is not there. Pramanya is there. Shruti has pramana, pramanatva. Shruti has pramanyam, and our conclusion of brahmani samanvaya, that is not shown to be faulty by the Puropakshi. It stands strongly on its feet. Therefore, tarthiya vicharaha bhavati iti hetu hit madbhava sangatya ayam adhyayaha arabhyate. So this third chapter is because such hetu is there. The hetu is there as to the nirakarana has been done of the avirodha, the establishment of avirodha by countering the virodha. Thereby some vichara, which is the resultant now, that is the third vichara, tartiya vicharaha bhavati. So you have to inquire now as to the resultant vichara after what the pramanyam was established by taking of apramanyam. And what are the apramanyam? The shloka vartika puramimamsaka says that in shloka vartika apramanyam tridha bhinnam. There are three types of apramanyam: mithya, mithyatva, ajnana, samshaya. So mithyatva, ajnana and samshaya are the things which are really apramana. So here virodha, which was pointed out, has raised samshaya, because everywhere in the sangati we have seen, not sangati but leading to the Puropaksha and Siddhanta division, we have seen iti samshaya, iti sandehe. So sandehe sati, sandehe prapte. So that sandehe samshaya, so that is one type of apramanyam. However, that was resolved. All those virodhas were shown to be improperly understood. Because of improper understanding, there was virodha seen by the Puropakshi. Such virodha does not exist. Therefore, samanvaya is established, and thereby tartiya vichara bhavati. There is a third vichara being done now. Hetu madbhava sangatya ayam adhyaya arabhyate. So there is some vichara pending now that there is no virodha in brahmani samanvaya. There is some vichara pending, that is the third chapter, that is which has led to the third chapter beginning. Purvam jiva upakarana bhuta bhautika janma nirupitam. So what is this third vichara that is being described now? Purvam, earlier what has been done? Jiva upakarana bhuta bhautika janma, or jiva upakarana bhuta bhautika janma. Both ways you can see. This bhautika janma, which was discussed in the last chapter, especially last pada, earlier pada, and then before that bhuta janma was discussed, or bhautika itself is in the form of upakarana of the jiva. So karana bhuta, upakarana bhuta is the bhautika, or you can take bhuta janma and bhautika janma, both ways it is okay. In the last pada what was discussed is bhautika janma, therefore you can take upakarana bhuta, whatever is bhautika. Whose upakarana? For jiva it is upakarana. So for jiva, whatever is in the form of upakarana, that is bhautika, and janma of the bhautika, prana, indriya, ityadi, were discussed in the last pada. Or bhuta janma was discussed, and then bhautika janma was also discussed. Both are what finally going to be upakarana for jiva. We'll take the first interpretation, simpler ones, because in the last bhautika, last adhikaranas, or the last pada, we have seen bhautika janma. Therefore we can take the bhautikas which are upakarana bhuta for the jiva, tesham janma nirupitam. The janma was discussed earlier. Tad upajivya tad upahitasya jivasya samsara prakaram vairagyartham nirupayitum dehantararambhe bhuta sukshma parishvaktis bhuta sukshma samparishvaktasya eva paraloka gamanam ityah. So now tadupajivya, taking that as a basis, tadupahitasya jivasya, the jiva who has bhautika, sharira, indriya, prana ityadi as upadhi, that kind of jivasya samsara prakaram. What is this samsara prakara? In which manner he has attained this samsara? दिस जीवा हु इज रियली शुद्ध आत्मा हैज टेकन द उपाधि ऑफ द शरीर त्रय विच आर भौतिक एंड देयर जन्म वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड फ्रॉम ब्रह्म इन द अर्लियर अध्याय अर्लियर पाद ऑल्सो. सो वॉट इज द संसार प्रकार ऑफ दिस जीव हु हैज भौतिक शरीर एज उपाधि. फॉर वॉट पर्पज शुड यू सी दिस संसार प्रकार. जीवा बींग अ संसार इज ट्रबल्ड. सॉरी. सो इज ट्रबल्ड. ही वॉन्ट्स टू गेट आउट एंड टू गेट आउट ही हैज टू नो वॉट इज द नेचर ऑफ द संसार. वॉट इज माई नेचर. हाउ डिड आई बिकम अ संसारी. वॉट इज दिस संसार रियली. हाउ इट इज अफेक्टिंग मी. हाउ आई कैन गेट अवे. ऑल दीज क्वेश्चन आर रिलेटेड. सो वैराग्यर्थम द संसार प्रकार डिस्कशन इज फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ वैराग्य. वैराग्यर्थम निरूपयितुम टू डिस्क्राइब दिस संसार प्रकार फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ वैराग्य फॉर दैट जीव. पर्पस ऑफ फॉर हूज पर्पस. फॉर द पर्पस हूज पर्पस इज बींग सर्व्ड. वैराग्य इज द पर्पस सर्व्ड फॉर द जीव. एंड वॉट कैंड ऑफ जीव दैट जीव इज तदुपहित. तदुपहित मीनिंग द भौतिक विच हैव बीन एस्टैब्लिश टू हैव जन्म फ्रॉम ब्रह्म. तद भौतिक उपहित जीव. जीवा हैज दोज भौतिक शरीर त्रया एज हिज शरीर एज इज उपाधि. नॉट एज शरीर एज इज उपाधि. सो निरूपयितुम देहांतर आरंभे भूत सूक्ष्म संपरिष्वक्तस्य एव परलोक गमनम इत्याह. टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ दिस जीवा हैज been continuing in samsara as a samsari, the journey from one sharira to another sharira has to be discussed, because jiva has no memory of earlier janma. That is revealed by the shastra, and as we saw that it is for the purpose of vairagya utpatti. Vairagya utpatti for the jiva. So dehantar arambhe, when the jiva has died and is going to take up another janma, then what is this jiva journey before the beginning of the other carried out prarabdha in another janma, in another sharira? So to begin that sharira, what all goes about? Dehantara anya dehaha dehantaram tasya dehantarasya arambhe. At the beginning of that, or in the beginning of that deha, what happens? This bhuta sukshma samparishvaktasya eva paraloka gamanam. Dehantara arambhe kasya gamanam. Paraloka gamanam kasya bhavati. This jiva has gone to various lokas and he is going to come into some other loka for janma. In this karma bhumi itself, he is going to come after his punya papa are exhausted. Punya or papa, whatever it is exhausted. He is going to take janma again because he does not have his swarupa jnana. He considers himself as a samsari jiva and his samsarana continues. So who is this jiva who is taking this janma? Dehantara arambhe. Here the saptami is a little tricky. Dehantara arambhe nimitta you can take. Nimitta saptami, but nimitta saptami technically it is used in this manner, but vyakrana wise it is very tricky. I'll not go into that right now, but you can. So I've been using adhikarana. Adhikarana is not working in translation. So towards, you can say towards the arambha of the deha or nimitta. Nimitta saptami you can say dehantara arambha nimitta. So for the nimitta is what dehantara arambha. For that this Jiva is going to have journey from one loka to another loka. So who is this Jiva who is having that journey? Kasya paraloka gamanam bhuta sukshma samparishvaktasya eva. One who is having this panchikrita bhuta. Bhuta sukshma is panchikrita bhuta, the sukshma ausha of the grossified, they are not sukshma mahabhutas. They are bhautikas only, which are panchikrita or trivritkrita, but they are the sukshma ausha of the bhautikas. What is the sukshma ausha? Sukshma sharira ityartha. You can take it as sukshma sharira. So, bhuta sukshma samparishvaktasya, one who is endowed with the bhuta sukshma, meaning sukshma sharira, that kind of jiva, tasyeva jivasya, tadupaitasya jivasya, bhuta sukshma samparishvaktasya eva jivasya, paraloka gamanam. That jiva is continuing from one loka to another for the purpose of taking janma in another deha. He has been travelling. Which kind of jiva has been travelling? That kind of jiva who has sukshma sharira along with him. So atma has sukshma sharira along with oneself as connected. It is not separated out. That connection remains after death. And this jiva who has the sukshma sharira as his upadhi, rather visheshana, that jiva travels, has gati, paraloka gamana. Iti aha. And thereby the adhikarana tadantara pratipatti adhikaranam. Tadantara pratipatti adhikarana has come up now as to the first adhikarana in the third adhyaya. Just give me one moment. I'm sorry. Okay. So, tadantara pratipatya adhikarana. So, the first sutra there is tadantara pratipatto ramhati samparishvakta prashna nirupanabhyam. Tadantara pratipatto ramhati samparishvakta prashna nirupanabhyam. So, tadantara pratipatya adhikarana. What does it say? The sutra, we'll see the adhikaranartha and the sutra together. Tadantara pratipattau ramhati samparishvaktaha prashna nirupanabhyam. Four padas are there. There is no padachheda needed. So this ramhati is gachati. Ramhati gachati. Tadantara pratipattau. Tadantara pratipattau is pratipatti, here is in the meaning of prapti. So tadantara pratipatti adhikarana is adhikarana section which is dealing with pratipatti prapti. Prapti of what? Tadantara. Tadantara is dehantara. Anyaha, saha anyaha is tadanyat. And tad there means deha. So, anyaha deha dehantaram tasya pratipattihi means prapti. Dehantarasya prapti ityartha. So, tadantara pratipattau means dehantara praptau. That is the name of the adhikarana. So, it's a difficult word. I was just trying to see how to put this together. Tadantara pratipatti adhikarana is pratipatti generally means elsewhere it will mean understanding. But here it is what? Prapti. Prapti of what? Prapti of Anyatat. What is that Anyatat? Anya Deha. So for the, what was it? Dehantara Arambhe Nimitte. So to attain the other Sharira, that is discussed in this Adhikarana. What goes about? So Tadantara Pratipattau Dehantara Praptau Ramhati. Ramhati is Gachati. Kaha Gachati? Samparishvakta Gachati. As it is said, Samparishvaktasya Eva Jivasya. हु इज संपरिष्वक्त जीव भूत सूक्ष्म संपरिष्वक्त हु इज एंडोर्ड विद दी और कनेक्टेड विद दी सूक्ष्म शरीर. सो दिस जीव इज दैट काइंड ऑफ अ जीव हु इज कनेक्टेड विद दी सूक्ष्म शरीर एंड ही इज हैविंग दिस जर्नी. देर बाय गच्छति देह गच्छति मीन्स परलोक गमनम मीन्स परलोके गच्छति और परलोकम गच्छति. का गच्छति संपरिष्वक्त जीव गच्छति भूत सूक्ष्म संपरिष्वक्त दैट जीव हु हैज सूक्ष्म शरीर संबंध सह जीव रंहति संपरिष्वक्त रंहति. सो भूतैः सम्यक् युक्तः इत्यर्थः. भूतैः सम्यक् युक्तः मीन्स संपरिष्वक्तः जीवः रंहति गच्छति. कुत्र गच्छति? देहांतर प्रतिपत्तौ अन्ये लोके गच्छति. देहांतर प्रतिपत्तौ टू प्राप्तौ टू अटेन दी फॉर दी पर्पस दैट निमित्त सप्तमी मीनिंग टू अटेन दैट अदर देहा विच इज रेडी फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर जीवा टू कंटिन्यू हिज संसरण दैट जीवा रंहति गच्छति. हाउ डू यू नो दैट इट इज दिस भूत सूक्ष्म और दी भौतिक सूक्ष्म शरीर युक्त जीव हु इज हैविंग दिस गमन परलोक गमन. सो देर दी हेतु इज गिवन एज प्रश्न निरूपणाभ्याम. इफ यू लुक एट दी प्रश्न एंड दी निरूपण उत्तर इन दी श्रुति देन अवगम्यते. सो सूत्रार्थ इज तदंतर प्रतिपत्तौ देहांतर प्राप्तौ रंहति गच्छति संपरिष्वक्तः भूतैः सम्यक् युक्तः सन् जीवः. कुतः कस्मात् कारणात् प्रश्न निरूपणाभ्याम अवगम्यते तथा. सो वी लुक एट दी क्वेश्चन एंड दी आंसर इन दी वृत्ति. अत्र पूर्वपक्षे निराधार प्राणादि गमन असंभवात् न वैराग्यम्. सिद्धांति इज सेइंग दैट ऑल दिस हैज टू बी अंडरस्टूड फॉर व्हाट पर्पस? फॉर वैराग्य. इट इज ए साधना. वैराग्य इज मुख्य साधना. इट इज नॉट ईजी टू गेट वैराग्य. स्मशान वैराग्य इज ईजी फॉर मेनी नॉट ऑल ऑल्सो. वेन समबडी डाइज बी इट वेरी क्लोज और नॉट वेरी क्लोज समबडी हु इज वेल नोन इफ वी एंड अप अटेंडिंग दी अंत्येष्टि go to smashana. Vairagya is resultant looking at the body being burnt, looking at all the attached people crying, so much of dukkha all around, you also become dukkhi. If we ourselves are connected with the person, a family man, somebody in the family dies, some loved ones die, then heart is broken, so much of dukkha we find very difficult to. If it is very close, then that part of love is lost. We find it very difficult to continue the life the way it was. We are used to that life. So there is lot of dukkha, and then such thinking is an end result as to, oh, what is this life? What is the purpose of this life? I have lost this person. I have lost that person. We place ourselves in the other person's shoes and think that so many desires were still unmet. What is this? What is the point? So much of suffering before dying. Whatever, all those ideas come to mind, and then vairagya. Why do I want to live that kind of a life? I want to change myself. Does not last for many. It can. Shastras accept that smashana vairagya can also lead to viveka janya vairagya, but not for all. Kashchid dhira. Without this smashana vairagya, viveka janya vairagya is extremely rare. But it is possible for some to even get vairagya from the smashana vairagya also. Now what is the Purvapakshi saying? Atra Purvapakshi niradhara pranadi gamana asambhavat na vairagyam. He says this pranadi gamana, when the person dies, what happens? Oh, prana is gone. Say prana is gone. That prana, niradhara prana cannot have gamana, says the Purva Pakshi. Asambhavat na vairagyam. This pranadi cannot have travel. Why? Because they are niradhara now. After death they are niradhara. How will the prana travel? The prana, see, when the sharira is walking, when the person was alive, then the prana was also going along with it. But when the sharira is dead, how will this prana travel? He is looking at the other way around. What do we say? Uska prana chala gaya. Prana ja raha hai. We talk about the prana going as the death of the body. The Purva Pakshi is saying the death of the body cannot let the prana travel anymore because prana was traveling in the body. So he is seeing it in that manner. What is our understanding? Generally, what do we say? Even Rudi Artha, we say that, oh, he lost his life. Life is prana. He lost his life, meaning the prana has left the body. That is death of the body. So prana is traveling. It has found its house in the residence for the time being. It was renting out the sharira as though it was a temporary resident of the sharira and it has left. This is what we say. Really, prana cannot travel without jiva. That is right. From the Purva Pakshi's perspective, the question has value. Niradhara, but he is, in his drishti, adhara was the deha. But adhara is not really deha at all for prana to travel. For everything which is jada, adhara is always atma, which is Satchidananda Swarupa. Satta and Chaitanya all are lent only by that Jivatma, Brahmatma. There is no other Satta Pradayaka, Chitta Pradayaka, Ananda Pradayaka. So Adhara is always Brahmatma, but it is lost on the Purva Pakshi. Atra Purva Pakshe Niradhara Pranadi Gamana Asambhavat Na Vairagyam. Where is this Vairagya going to be possible? Because Prana does not have any travel without Adhara. This is what the Purva Pakshi is saying. Therefore, this Jiva cannot get Vairagya looking at the Prana travel. Prana cannot travel because Adhara is not there. Siddhante Tatsambhavat Vairagyam Iti Phalaveda. In Siddhanta, Vairagya is definitely possible. Why? Because Pranagamana is possible. Why? How is Pranagamana possible? Jiva Gamana is possible. Sukshma Sharira and Jiva, Atma put together is this Jiva who is traveling. Who is the samsari really? Transmigrator. Saha Jivaha kim dehantara arambakaihi panchikruta bhuta bhagaihi asamparishvaktaha gachyati uta samparishvakta iti sandehe. Now that Jiva, who has Gamana really, whereby Prana travels, Jiva Pranadharani, you look at it, Prana does not travel, Purva Pakshi can also be saying that Jiva cannot have a travel, so Vairagya is not possible. That may be the real meaning there, because that's what makes sense. All Pranadi, Pranadi is, if you look at Jiva Pranadharani, who retains Prana, that Jiva cannot have travel, is the real question hidden behind that construct of Niradhara Pranadi Gamana Asambhava. Meaning Jiva cannot travel, that may be the idea behind that question expressed in that manner. And Siddhante Tatsambhavat means Jivasya Gamana Sambhavat Vairagyam Jivasyeva Bhavati Bhavitam Arhati Iti Phalabheda. Now Sahajivaha, because Sahajiva has been said, there is no Jiva discussed here at all. Or you can say Jivasya Vairagyam, therefore Sajivaha. I would prefer to say that Jivasya Gamanam. In the earlier sentence, Jiva Gamana is the outcome. How is that the outcome? Niradhara Pranadi Gamana Asambhavat. And Tat Sambhavat means Adhara Sambhavat and Pranadi Gamana Sambhavat, therefore Vairagya Sambhava. Just give me a moment, please. So therefore the gamana of jiva is possible. Now who is that jiva? Sahajiva kim dehantara arambakaihi panchikruta bhuta bhagaihi asamparishvaktah gachyati ramhati. Does this jiva travel unconnected, asamparishvaktah, unconnected with what? with panchikrita bhuta bhagas. The panchikrita bhuta bhagas meaning bhuta sukshmas, which are really sukshma sharira, sukshma osha of the sharira there, which are what? Dehantara arambhaka. So dehantara arambhakaihi saha, these are going to help the person enter another sharira, and they are what? Panchikrita bhuta bhaga sukshma sharira. Taihi sa samparishvakta gachati, parts of the sukshma sharira, because plural is there, so you can say parts of the sukshma sharira, bhuta sukshma. Is he not connected with them when he has gamana, or uta samparishvakta iti sande, or is he connected with these parts of bhuta sukshmas? Iti sandehe prapte sati, when this doubt comes up, mana bhava, there is no pramana for jiva being connected with these bhuta sukshmas, says the purvapakshi. Mana bhavat asamparishvakta iti purvapaksha, he says jiva is not connected with them after death, sharira is gone, all sharira is gone, jiva is not connected anymore, therefore he is unconnected. Siddhantastu tadantara pratipattau dehantara pratipattau, tadantara pratipattau visvani mula dehantara pratipattau praptau tad arambhakrutaihi tad arambhaka bhutaihi, sorry, tad arambhaka bhutaihi samparishvakta rauhati gacchati, he is connected with these, and these sukshma shariras hold samskaras, they will not so bhuta sukshmas, sukshma sharira aunshas which are bhuta sukshmas, they hold, they are bhautikas, they also hold the samskara, the karma of the jiva, all the janma janmantara adi janmataha prapta, adi janma which is anadi janma, anadi janmataha prapta samskaras are stored in this antakarana itself. Avidya bija rupa and then manifested, hidden in the antakarana, which is part of this sukshma sharira, and with multiple parts you can say that with bhuta sukshmas. Therefore, this jiva cannot be disconnected at all. In fact, he is never disconnected unless jnanotpatti takes place leading to jivan mukti, and visheshata antakarana being there in some form for prarabdha to tick, until there is no videha mukti, where these antakarana or the bhuta sukshmas are also, which are panchikrita, are reversed into apanchikrita, sukshma mahabhutas, and then into Brahma. So, till they are completely reversed on videha mukti, till then this jiva is definitely connected with the manifest and unmanifest bhuta sukshmas, sukshma sharira. He is never going to let it go. That itself defines him as manifest jiva, an individual who is thinking himself as a samsari and wants to get away. So he cannot be disconnected from the sukshma sharira. Even in bija avastha, he is definitely connected. So samparishvaktaha jivaha ramhati gachyati kutaha kasmat karanat, why so? Prashna nirupanabhya, because there are questions and answers. So in the shastra, what is that? Vetha yatha panchamyam ahuta vapaha purusha vachaso bhavanti iti prashnaha. What is the question there? So there is a question, I'll mention these details later, but there are five ahutis, and then jiva goes through these five ahutis. In the panchamyam ahuta, vetha, do you know, ask the panchala raja to shvetaketu. Or let me just give the story also. It's a very short thing as to the Shvetaketu Brahmana of this Chandogya Upanishad, Shashto Adhyaya. We've seen he has jnana of all the four Vedas, and then his father becomes a teacher and gives him the Atma Jnana also. Now this Shvetaketu goes to Panchala King, and Panchala Raja has already heard, he is a Kshatriya, he has already heard this Brahmana Shvetaketu's garva of knowing Chaturveda, having Chaturveda Panditya, he knows all this. So when Shvetaketu goes there as a Brahmana in the Sabha, the Panchala Raja insults him. Panchala Raja has the Upasana and the Upasana Jnana. He has knowledge of the Karma Kanda and Upasana Kanda very well. He knows the Gati of the Jiva very well. How this Jiva takes Janma, he knows all of that very well. So that Kshatriya Raja, he has such jnana. So to insult this Shvetaketu to test his knowledge and insult him, because he has so much of garva, the Panchala king says, asks him, do you know Vetha? Tom Vetha, do you know? Yatha panchamyam ahutau apaha purusha vachasaha bhavanti apaha jala jala become what? Purusha vachasa means purushakhya. How this jala itself is called as purusha jiva, meaning how does this jala in the fifth ahuti, how this jala becomes jiva? That is the prashnartha there. Do you know Vetha? Iti prashna. The Shvetaketu feels insulted. He says that, how can this Raja ask me such a question? I do not know the answer. He does not know the answer. So obviously he is insulted. His, especially his bloated ego. The ego which was there, that is punctured completely. Ju parjanya prithivi purushayo shitsu panchasu agnishu shraddha soma vrishti anna reto rupaha panchahutihi. So there is a There are these five ahutis, Panchagni Vidya. So each of this, there are five ahutis whereby there is a jiva born finally as a result of the fifth ahuti. So there is a Agni in each ahuti, equivalent to Agni, where ahuti is given, and then there is a resultant born. That itself becomes an ahuti for the next, in next ahuti, it becomes the dravya for the next ahuti. And so on, finally the jiva is born. So we'll not go into so much of details. Dyu, Parjanya, Prithvi, Purusha and Yoshit. These are the five Agnis. So the Swarga, Parjanya, the Vrishti, the rains, and then Prithvi, Purusha and Yoshit. Purusha is male and Yoshit is female. So these are the five Agnis. So jiva travels like this. How is the journey of the jiva? Who has attained Swargaloka, ityadi, other loka? From there he will come in the form of rains, and then in the form of prithvi, where Anna Rupa is eaten by Ahuti for Purusha. Then it will become the seed of the Purusha. Then in the union it will enter the jiva enters the Yoshit, and then in the form of the womb finally born as jiva. Jiva as in a particular samsari jiva in the taking janma. So panchasu agnishu, these are the five agnis, and what is the ahuti there respectively? Shraddha is first ahuti to Dyu, and then Parjanya to Soma, Chandra, and then Prithvi, Vrishti. So Vrishti is the ahuti, then Retaha is the ahuti. So Shraddha, Soma, Vrishti, Anna, Anna, Vrishti, Anna, Reta. So Shraddha is the first ahuti, then Soma is the ahuti, Vrishti is the ahuti, then Anna is the ahuti, Retaha finally is the ahuti whereby the child is born and then takes the form of the samsari jiva. So these are the forms. Shraddha, Soma, Vrishti, Anna, Reto, Rupaha, Panchahuti, they are offered respectively into Dyu, Parjanya, Prithvi, Purusha, Yoshitsu, Panchaswa, Agnishu. In these five Agnis, this is the Panchagni Vidya, which is very well known to Panchala Raja, but Shvetaketu does not know it. His father has not taught him. He asks, what has your father taught? Has your father taught you this? So he says, no, I have not been taught of this Vidya. And there were Panchahuti Darshayitva, having shown these five Ahutis, iti tu Panchamyam Ahutav Apav Purusha Vachasa Bhavanti. And finally, the answer is what? In this manner, in the fifth ahuti, the jala, reto rupa, basically the reta, becomes what? Purusha vachasa. It takes the akhya of Purusha. Finally, it is born as Purusha jiva in a male or a female body. Iti nirupadam prativachanam. This is the answer. Tabhyam ityartha. Due to this prashna and uttara. Uttara Shvetaketu does not give. And then he goes to his father crying, saying that this Raja is not a Raja. He is not a Rajanya at all. He is Rajanya Bandhu. He has so much of garva, he insulted me. Then the father asked, what question did he ask you? The son says, he asked me this kind of a question. The father also does not know the answer, but the father wants to learn. He says, let's go to Panchala Raja, let's learn. एंड द फादर इज वेरी वेल रिस्पेक्टेड, ही डज नॉट हैव सच गर्व. सो उद्दालक सॉरी श्वेतकेतुस फादर गोज टू पंचाल राजा एंड लर्न्स द विद्या फ्रॉम हिम. ही वॉज ऑफर्ड धना बट देन ही रिफ्यूज इज धना. ही सेज दैट यू टीच मी. सन डज नॉट जॉइन, श्वेतकेतु डज नॉट जॉइन. एंड देन दिस ज्ञाना विच वॉज नॉट देयर विद ब्राह्मणा देन इट वॉज देयर विद क्षत्रिय कम्स टू ब्राह्मणस फ्रॉम दी पंचाल राजा. पंचाल राजा वेन इज ऑफरिंग दी दक्षिणा टू द ब्राह्मणा दैट टाइम ही सेज दैट आई डू योर पूजा एंड गिव यू दक्षिणा. बट देन द ब्राह्मणा वेन ही सेज दैट यू टीच मी देन द पंचाल राजा सेज यू स्टे हियर फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम. सो यू हैव टू स्टे एंड सर्व सर्व इन द सेंस यू हैव टू बिहेव लाइक एन अंतेवासी एज अ स्टूडेंट नॉट एज अ गुरु एनी मोर. सो द ब्राह्मणा इज नो लॉन्गर अ गुरु देर एंड ही इज नॉट समवन हु इज वर्दी ऑफ वर्शिप एनी मोर. सो instead of dana teaching is given as dana, therefore the brahmana has to wait to show the shishya bhava, meaning the bhava of a student to learn, and then the raja teaches looking at his vritti, and then this answer was given, the panchagni vidya was taught to him, thereby he learns. So this is the prashna and nirupana. We'll look at the next sutra in the next part, next patha. Wanted to cover at least one complete sutra there. Amnayante samsiddham adhi madhyanta varjitam anandagharam apurnam atma jyotir upasmahe. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Namaste.
Namaste.